It's fair to say the last 18 months have been a time of ups and downs, really, for the rapper Professor Green. He married the heiress Millie McIntosh, and the couple recently celebrated their first anniversary.
He has also, though, been injured in a car accident and, in a separate incident, faced drink driving charges. As a result, he says himself that he struggled at times to deal with his own anxiety and emotions.
Some of these experiences have influenced the music in his new album. Here's a listen to his latest single.
It's been a while since I last dreamt. Barely remember what it's like to dream. Finding it hard to get to sleep, too stressed, and there ain't anyone to sing a lullaby to me. Pretend she doesn't get to me, and I suffer in silence when I'm hurting. A man's problems are his own, and it's my burden. Tossing and turning, trying to get to sleep, but I find it hard to switch off when my mind's working. I ponder on things I shouldn't bother with. Off the rails, my train of thoughts wandering. Sick of pretending to be so happy, all the while my anxiety eats away at me, my skin crawls. I look up at the sky and it falls. The walls closing and it's as if all the good in my life disappears in an instant. Happiness is so distant. So seem the ones who I love, the ones who love me, but I don't wanna tell them how I feel in case they judge me. It's just me. Wish I could let somebody in, but I ain't ever been too trusting.
All the time.
Stephen Manderson, I can hardly call you that, really, but Professor Green, most people know you.
All his Stephen. Friends call
good
him
morning.
Steve.
Good probably morning. Probably call you Steve, actually,
they
don't they?
They call me far worse, to be honest.
Oh, do they? Let's not. Oh, it's lovely to see you again. Thanks very
nice
much.
To be back.
Yes. And that's Lullaby, which is on the new album.
Yeah.
Gosh, it's an emotional song when you listen to the lyrics.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about it.
I guess the song really is about something that a lot of men don't talk, well, a lot of people don't talk about. But especially men, because you have the added pressure of having to be masculine and be macho. But it's about depression. It's not a depressing song. It's about the resolve, about coming out the other side of it. The last lyrics, that things always change as long as you give them a chance to. And the sad thing that happens, as in my instance with my father, is when people, I think the line is, they make a permanent decision to solve a temporary problem.
Mm. Mm.
So I just thought it would do a bit of good.
Yeah, but you would think that somebody, or people would think, in somebody in your position, happily newly married, successful young artist, etc., going places, getting, you know, things happen, you think he's got to be on top of the world.
Yeah.
But it seems you're not necessarily.
Not all the time. I think a lot of people have this misconception that if you become successful in something, that it'll absolve you of all your problems. I did at a point. And then you become successful and you realize that actually you still have good and bad days, because that's life.
Mm.
And it doesn't matter what level of success you have, you're still affected by things.
And one of the lyrics in the song is, I think sometimes I wish someone would tell me it's all going to be all right.
Yeah, that was where I actually wrote a song with Ina Roldson and Chris Loco, and I was telling them a story about my great grandmother and how I used to top and tail with her, because we were six in a three-bedroom flat when I was born, and she used to have an armchair in the living room that folded out into her bed, and I'd wake up before everyone else and top and tail with her under her blue blanket and read a page of a book to each other before the cartoons come on.
Yeah.
And we're just talking about how when you're a kid, if you're fortunate, because not everyone's lucky enough to have this, you have a person who tells you everything's going to be all right and you believe them no matter what. But then at a certain age, you go, actually, you know what, sometimes everything isn't going to be okay. And you kind of long for that security again.
Mm. So much to talk about, because you talk about things change, so then perhaps it can become okay.
Yeah.
I mean, it's very interesting what you say, particularly about young men. And it's not just young men feeling in a very difficult place, and that you didn't know how to talk or didn't talk about it. So where did you go in the end, and how did you kind of come out of
this? To my pad.
Right.
Yeah, my pen and my pad. And that, for me,
right,
it's good,
okay,
because I've got that expression, haven't I? So it's nice to have that, to express myself, which a lot of people don't have.
Mm. What's your advice to other people who are sort of in a similar dark place?
I guess the most important thing to realise is that you're not the only person that feels like it, because you can become quite insular when you feel like that, and you feel as though you are, and you start maybe doing things to make things worse rather than make them better. Mm. So the important thing is just to realise it.
Some people come into the studio a couple of minutes late because they get stuck in the lift or things in makeup. So you're a year late, actually.
I remember you saying this time last year.
No, they said, Steve's coming in, and I waited.
I've missed you as well.
I've missed you, bro.
Yeah, all right.
Is that all right? but it's because of events.
Yeah.
It has been a bumpy ride.
It has. I was walking out my house with my bag to a gig, and some silly sod in a car had his foot on the brake.
Some silly person.
Person, sorry. Good. The car had eco, so the engine was off. So he was sat there with his foot on the brake. He had forgot he hadn't turned the car off. Obviously took his foot off the brake and felt the engine start just as I was walking between the two cars and panicked, went to slam his foot on the brake and hit the accelerator and squashed me between another car. Luckily, I jumped, so the only thing that got caught was my left leg. But that left me off my feet for a couple of months and on. I can't take anti-inflammatory, so I was on slow-release morphine, codeine and tramadol. My skin was itching. That was the beginning of a dark time, to be honest.
I can imagine.
That's very interesting. And what about, so you've been married, your first year's anniversary?
Yeah, just gone September the 10th. Who'd have thought it? I wouldn't. It's crazy.
Yeah, you write about it on...
Maybe not in a way that she was entirely happy with it.
Exactly, which gives us license to talk about it, which is great. Yeah. Because I've often thought, as you're never far from my thoughts, but I've often thought it must be a challenge to marry somebody from your background, particularly a challenge for anybody, somebody from your background to marry into such a well-off family.
Oh, no, but do you know what? I think we're both very equal in where we are now. And something that my grandmother always told me was that your class isn't dictated by what you've got in your pocket or in the bank. It's by your manners and how you treat other people. So because of that, I've never felt uncomfortable in any situation, no matter who I'm around. Yeah. And I was nervous when I first met her parents, not because of who they are or what they've come from, but because they're her parents, as you're always nervous. And my whole past, some true, some twisted, some completely fabricated, is all online.
I just think they might
be
nervous.
They can go on Google.
Right.
And, yeah, they might be nervous meeting you.
I was lucky because they're, you know, it's testament to what great people they are. They've only ever taken me as the person that they've met and they've never judged me on anything else.
So Bill was saying a year late, but the album is there and we're just going to have a look at another single from it. This is Not Your Man.
Yeah.
What you take me for? What you take me for? Gave you everything, yet you're still looking at me like I could've gave you more. Gave you more? I ain't got anything left to give. Somebody better know if I'm next to kin, cause the stress is killing me. Either you're feeling me or you're not. Either way, I ain't gonna be spending any more money in Tiffany. I'm done with that. What you think I rap for? To buy you a bag, are you mad? I'm a catch. The type of man women normally go mad for. Sick of love, sick of you, wish I was, but I ain't no. James like a boy in trance, anything you ask for, I can't say no. Don't give, but you take loads.
The DNA's
in find hard to balance sometimes is the delightful, charming, pleasant you are here on the sofa. With when you listen to the music and the style of rapping, it comes across as sort of quite aggressive.
I think rapping is inherently quite aggressive, though, isn't it? But I don't think you have to be aggressive all the time. It takes a lot of energy to walk around being angry all the time, doesn't it?
And tell us about which is your favourite song on the album?
This album. Yeah. Have to be Lullaby and In the Shadow of the Sun. Yeah. More thoughtful tracks on the album. Yeah.
How do you choose the songs that go with your composition?
Oh, so like the music underneath them. We normally make them on the spot. So I'll go in the studio with the producer. Like with Lullaby, Chris was just playing chords on the piano. And he played something and we went, that's what we want to work on.
And it does make me nervous when we play some of your songs because there is less... bad words, fewer bad words, I should say, in this one, isn't it? Is that a conscious thing? But they are still there.
No, not at all. I don't know. I don't think you need to use that much profanity, even if you want to cause offence, actually. Sometimes it's better to...
You might suggest that to Robbie Williams next time he makes a guest appearance.
That was a giggle, wasn't it? I thought as I took a little jab at him on the song, it was only right I gave him the chance to have one back.
Very funny.
So he's on one of them. Lovely to see you again.
Thank you very much for having me.
See you soon. Thank you.
Professor Green's new album, Growing Up in Public, is available from next week.